Number 12. Underwater Buddha Statue. Renovation works often reveal long-forgotten objects, but workers in the Jiangxi province couldn't have possibly expected to find something of such significance as they began construction of a hydropower gate on a reservoir. The work caused the water levels in the area to fall, which revealed a 600-year-old Buddha statue looking peacefully out. It's thought that the statue dates back to the Ming Dynasty or maybe even earlier. What's more, it was just the first sign of archaeological significance there, because the base of an ancient temple was also found under the water. Archaeologists found that the reservoir had been built on the ruins of an ancient town called Xiaoxi, meaning that all the treasures that were too large to move were flooded. Surprisingly, the presence of water is thought to have helped preserve the Buddha, which is why it looks in such great condition, even though it's been there for more than six centuries. Number 11. Ancient Chinese Tomb. In the northern Shaanxi province of China, a mysterious tomb has been discovered, built of brick and stone that dates back over 800 years. The tomb itself was discovered near the office building of a metal company when they decided to do a renovation project. They were shocked to find an absolutely massive underground burial hidden beneath the concrete. Researchers evaluated the tomb to be from the Jin Dynasty, sometime between 960 and 1234 AD. How exactly it got covered up by concrete when the city was being built is quite frankly boggling. It was literally inches beneath the ground. People must have been walking over the tomb for nearly 1,000 years without ever taking notice. The researchers aren't sure who was buried here. Hao Xiaoqiao with the Tourism Bureau said it may have been a couple's joint tomb, though who they were is anybody's guess. Number 10. Tools rewrite human history. It's pretty incredible to think that no matter how far we come in the fields of science and technology, the world is still full of secrets and splendor left to be found. This is the case when it comes to human history, and the Philippines may have held a special key to rewriting it. There were stone tools found there that predate the arrival of modern humans to the islands by around 600,000 years. Near the tools were the remains of carved bones, most likely between 631,000 and 777,000 years old. Before this discovery, the earliest evidence of ancient humans was found in Luzon's Caliao Cave, and it was a 67,000-year-old foot bone. It means that the occupation of an ancient species of human to the Philippines was much earlier than originally believed. It was thought that humans didn't cross to the islands because they weren't sure how to get across such an expansive ocean. But it turns out that ancient humans were able to make significant deep-sea crossings much sooner than originally believed. Number 9. Nomad's Shield. An incredible shield that once belonged to a nomadic warrior has been found by archaeologists in China's Xinjiang region, which they say is over 3,000 years old. This is actually a pretty mysterious part of China, bordering closely with Mongolia. The Nomad's Shield was found by the Huahaize Lake in the Altai Mountains, a place where archaeologists once found what they think is the largest temple ever dedicated to the sun in the Eurasian steppe. The stone shield itself is shaped kind of like a pentagon and was used during the Bronze Age by ancient nomads for ritual sacrifice ceremonies. Associate researcher with the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences, Guo Wu, said the shield was a ritual object intended to drive out evil spirits. The nomads at the time were focused primarily on shamanism as their religion. In order to bless the shield, turning it into a magical totem to ward off away evil spirits, somebody probably had to be sacrificed, and the shield blessed by a shaman. However, the specific details of the ritual are still unknown to scientists. Number 8. Saka Warrior Relics. Golden objects were recently uncovered from ancient burial mounds that were created by the Saka Warriors of Central Asia, a group of people who lived from between the 8th century BC to the 3rd century BC. Hundreds of amazing gold artifacts were taken from dozens of burial mounds throughout the Kazakhstan wasteland. One of the burial plots even belonged to a teenage archer who was buried with a small collection of golden objects and a young female who was found to be a relative. His tomb was found completely intact, which shocked archaeologists because most of the tombs had already been pillaged by grave robbers centuries ago. The Saka people themselves are some of the most fascinating anywhere in Asia. They were known to be fearsome warriors and skilled artisans. They created intricate objects out of gold and fought other nomadic tribes in the region. They were ultimately wiped out about 2,000 years ago, with very little remaining of their legacy today, except for what's been found in the burial mounds of their most prominent warriors. Number 7. Imperial Worship. Archaeologists in China have excavated an imperial worship site that was built over 1,500 years ago. This was during the Northern Wei Dynasty of between 386 and 534 AD. It's the first time that archaeologists have located such a site, which they say was probably used in the worshipping of heaven itself. Historical records even show that the Emperor Xiaowen visited this place to conduct a ceremony in 494 AD before he relocated his state capital. But what was heaven worship for the ancient Chinese? Its history goes back to the Chao Dynasty of 1046 BC. It was a key ceremony for emperors to pay tribute to heaven in hopes that they would get good weather the following year. They didn't have quite as complicated a system of beliefs as some other ancient civilizations. They simply requested that heaven, which ruled over earth, would provide them a good harvest. Heaven worship went on for 3,000 years before the government of the Republic of China banned such ceremonies in 1914. Number 6. World's Earliest Coin. The oldest coins ever minted in human history were just found in China in 2021. This discovery shocked the entire scientific community. The coins found date back to at least 2640 years. They are known as spade coins, crafted in what is today the Henan province. Archaeologists also found the production site where the coins were minted, part of an industrial foundry active during the Eastern Qiao period between 770 and 220 BC. Before this amazing discovery, the oldest coins ever found were unearthed in Turkey, thought to be just a few years younger than these ones. The Chinese spade coins were shaped kind of like the head of a shovel, with a hollow socket in the middle. Characters were written on the coins to mark how much they were worth. There were a few different versions of these coins that circulated throughout China until 221 BC, when they were outlawed by the first emperor of Qin. Unfortunately, nobody knows just how widespread the use of these coins was. The city in which the artifacts were found was established in the year 800 BC and then abandoned less than 400 years later. The coins may only have been in production for a short period before they grew out of style. Do you like old coins? Do people still collect coins these days? Let me know in the comments below and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Number 5. Ancient Idol. An ancient sculpture over 1200 years old was just found in a riverbed in India by the police. According to the local officials, miners in the area were digging up the riverbed when they stumbled upon the artifact and called the authorities. It's believed that the sculpture represents the goddess Durga, known as the mother of the Hindu universe. She goes by other names too, such as Shakti or Devi. She is one of the most popular Hindu goddesses, seen as the protector of all that is good in the physical world. She does battle with the forces of evil and is often depicted standing atop a lion or tiger. Nobody knows exactly where the statue came from or how it ended up on the bottom of the river. It's been dated back to the 7th century, to a time when thousands of Hindu temples were being erected all across the country. This very statue may have been pillaged from one of the nearby temples, then discarded in the river and lost for centuries. Number 4. Noyon Mountain Burial. The Xiongnu Empire was at one point the most powerful empire anywhere in Asia. The Xiongnu people were the ancient ancestors of the Mongols and predate the Mongol Empire as the first great civilization in the grasslands of Central Asia. These people occupied a massive stretch of territory going all the way from Manchuria to the Altai Mountains, even as far as Lake Baikal in Siberia. They controlled many parts of the Silk Road and interacted with the more famous Han Dynasty. Before the Xiongnu Empire fell apart and then reformed as the Mongol Empire, they left behind at least 5,000 tombs across Mongolia, China, and Russia. It's important to remember at this point that Russia is a little bit European and a little bit Asian. The European part of Russia is Moscow, while in the Far East, in Siberia, the heritage is almost entirely Asian. In any case, many of the amazing tombs of the Xiongnu elite have been uncovered by archaeologists. The most famous is the Noyon Mountain burial site found in 1912. It's here where the deepest of all the elite tombs is, going nearly 60 feet down in the earth. The walls of the tombs at this site were found covered in felt rugs with coffins adorned with silk and fancy textiles. Rather than funerary objects dedicated to obscure gods, most of the artifacts found inside the tombs are representations of the sun and the moon. Number 3. Ancient bones. Newly discovered bones of a person who died 40,000 years ago have revealed some secrets of Asia's distant history. To understand the discovery a bit better, keep in mind that humans left Africa and spread into Eurasia 60,000 years ago. After this, humans fanned out pretty much everywhere, but the story of how humans ended up in East Asia, meaning places like Japan, Korea, and Taiwan, is still a bit foggy. Nobody knows who settled which region first or how exactly the different civilizations structured themselves in the very beginning. Dr. Chow Mei Fu at the Institute of Vertebrate Paleontology and Paleoanthropology in Beijing is trying to make sense of this ancient history. Members of her team recently extracted and sequenced the DNA of someone called the Tianyan Man. This guy died 40,000 years ago in what is now Western Beijing. He's considered to be one of the earliest human beings ever found in East Asia. After taking a close look at his DNA, scientists discovered that no human alive today shares the same genetic makeup as him. As you can imagine, these results have stirred up quite a bit of confusion. Scientists don't understand how his genes have vanished from human society. The best guess is that the DNA of early hunter-gatherers was diluted during mass migration to and from the area, with the more prominent genes of the natives in Southeast Asia eventually becoming dominant. Number 2. T-Rex bird. In China, researchers discovered the fossil of an ancient bird that shares a shocking similarity with a Tyrannosaurus rex. The discovery was made by researchers working with the Chinese Academy of Sciences. The fossil dates back to 120 million years, back to when this small extinct bird once flapped around with the dinosaurs. The bird was so small that it could easily fit in the palm of a person's hand. The reason it's so unique is that its skull looks almost identical to that of a T-Rex, just quite a bit smaller. By reconstructing the skeleton of the dead bird, researchers were able to determine that the earliest bird to ever take flight inherited many of their features from their dinosaur ancestors. However, what scientists can't figure out is how a giant T-Rex ended up slowly evolving into what was basically a predatory hummingbird. Number 1. Ancient skeletons. Giants have been found in China. Archaeologists recently uncovered the skeletons of people who were unusually tall and unusually powerful. The skeletons date back 5,000 years and were pulled out of the ground at a gravesite in the Shandong province. One of the giants measured 6 feet 2 inches. This may not sound like a lot, especially not to anyone who's ever watched a basketball game, but it is a shocking height for 5,000 years ago. Back then, people were closer to being 5 feet tall. Plus, the average man in China today is only 5 feet 6 inches tall, a full 6 inches shorter than the ancient giants. Nobody knows exactly who these people were, but archaeologists noted they were buried in larger tombs than ordinary people. The reason was probably that they had a very high status in society, which could have been because of their incredible height. It's unclear what made a random group of people significantly taller than everyone else around them, although that tallness persists today. A study in 2015 showed that the people living in the Shandong province are still slightly taller than the rest of the people in China. As of right now, nobody has any idea why. Do you think giants really lived in China 5,000 years ago? Let me know in the comments and thank you for watching. Be sure to hit subscribe and come back again for another wild video.